Number 10, the Viking Helmet. The Viking helmets found at Vindel, one of the most impressive archaeological sites in all of Sweden, are nothing short of incredible. Researchers first uncovered these incredible historical artifacts back in 1929, and since then, they've found priceless treasures there from back during the Dark Ages. The burial grounds where these helmets were uncovered were used from between 550 and 800 AD. This period is also known as the Vindel period. We only know about it because of written accounts by other people in Europe, seeing as the Vikings didn't leave any written records of their own. They were more focused on pillaging and killing others than on writing down stories of their exploits. Fortunately for us, some of the people that they invaded did take notes. The only things the Vikings themselves left behind, though, were artifacts being buried deep inside of graves waiting to be excavated by archaeologists. The Vindel helmets were almost certainly made in Scandinavia, though historians still aren't sure how they became so popular with the Vikings. They might have been inspired by Roman helmets used in the later part of the Roman Empire, and some suggest the Vikings may have been particularly inspired by the gladiatorial helmets. But today, the collection of well-preserved Vindel artifacts, helmets included, can be seen on display in Sweden, and sometimes in special exhibitions around the world. What would you do if you lived in a village being invaded by the Vikings? Would you fight back or just hope that they were merciful invaders? Let me know down in the comments. Number 9, the Pit of Death. In Russia, a series of terrifying death pits containing at least 300 bodies have been discovered. The disturbing site was found in the old city of Yaroslavl. Archaeologists are saying the death pits probably date back to when the Mongols invaded Europe in the year 1238. This was a time when Genghis Khan's grandson, Batu Khan, was destroying entire communities and burning them to the ground. DNA evidence uncovered from bodies inside the death pits have shown that some of the victims were related. Experts from Russia's own Institute of Archaeology have now painted a picture as to why the people were dumped into the graves and who exactly they were. We have to go back to the birth of Yaroslavl. It was founded between 998 and 1010 during the rule of Yaroslavl the Wise. Mongol troops attacked the city in 1257 and murdered quite a lot of people. Imagine being in a city getting invaded by the Mongols. You'd probably curl up into a ball and cry. The idea of a Mongol invasion goes directly against some scholars, who have argued that Mongols' Golden Horde acquired its Russian territory peacefully. The Mongols clearly didn't. They definitely slaughtered people in the hundreds and then dumped them into death pits. Judging by the brutality inflicted on these people, clearly seen by archaeologists when inspecting the bones, the attack on the city was brutal and ruthless, and literally ended in the city drowning in blood. Number 8, ancient rock art. Archaeologists in France discovered what they believe could be the oldest rock art in Europe ever. It was found in 2012 when the archaeologists were investigating an ancient rock shelter. They turned over a broken slab of limestone and came face to face with a piece of rock that had been etched with pictures of aurochs. What's so exciting about this is that aurochs have been extinct for a very long time, but were hunted across much of Europe by our earliest ancestors thousands and thousands of years ago. Radiocarbon dating placed the engraved piece of rock at being 38,000 years old. This was a time even before the ending of the last ice age, when all kinds of amazing beasts roamed Europe. According to anthropologist Randall White from New York University, this was a time when humans had just begun to start to spread across the continent. Hunter-gatherers would have hibernated inside of the rock shelter where the artwork was found, keeping warm through the winter. One winter, 38,000 years ago, an unknown caveman became one of the first artists in existence. Number 7. Ancient Baltic Sea Ship. Divers from Finland have discovered a ship in the depths of the Baltic Sea that dates back to 400 years. This amazing discovery is shedding light on the boating history of the 17th century. The boat is an example of a Dutch vloot, a kind of ship that was used in trading in the 1600s. In fact, the vloot is one of the first boats made specifically for cargo. It was found at the mouth of the Gulf of Finland in exceptional condition. The Baltic Sea is actually one of the best places to find wooden ships because of the freezing temperatures. Microorganisms have a hard time flourishing in the Baltic Sea meaning wooden ships can last much longer without being broken down. The area was important for trade 400 years ago. Some of the ships sailing through the Baltic Sea were the first in what would become a network of globalized trade. This particular ship was found roughly 300 feet deep and had not sustained much damage. Nobody's really sure why it sank, and nobody knows what the name of the ancient Scandinavian vessel is. But researchers are hoping to discover more about the original cargo ship's design and why it went out of style by the 18th century. Number 6. Athens Mass Grave. In a rather disturbing discovery, the remains of 80 men shackled together at the wrist have been discovered in a mass grave near Athens. These skeletons date back to the 7th century BCE, a time when Athens was being ruled by aristocrats who held great power through land ownership. But Athens was in a position to change, with a new type of government on the horizon, one known as a tyrant. The 80 men found buried together were all aged between 20 and 30. They had each been killed with a single fatal blow to the skull. This means they had probably been executed one at a time, completely helpless. But just who were these men? They were likely part of a failed coup that tried to oust the aristocrats and place an Olympic champion in the seat of power, creating a mega tyrant. The coup failed, these guys got busted, they ended up shackled, executed, and buried. Number 5. Pyramid Energy. According to a new study done by Russian and German scientists, the Khufu Pyramid at Giza is able to produce electromagnetic energy with some of its internal chambers. This is a pretty out-to-lunch study, but apparently when the chambers inside the pyramid are hit with radio waves, they produce energy. Scientists analyzed how the energy is focused inside of the chambers, reaching a conclusion that the Great Pyramid reacts to certain types of energy waves. However, there was no conclusion as to what the energy could have been used for. Scientists don't actually understand how this is happening. Certain radio waves seem to excite the inside of the pyramid, creating a surge of electromagnetic energy near its point. But we can't possibly hope to understand what this means or what it was used for thousands of years ago. For all we know, there could be a different type of radio wave that forces the pyramid to react in a way that we can't even imagine. Number 4. The Dino Impact. Recent fossil evidence has been discovered at the Talltanic site in North Dakota, containing evidence of the asteroid that killed the dinosaurs. 66 million years ago, an asteroid hit the Yucatan Peninsula of Mexico, global devastation ensued, and we had the 5th mass extinction on Earth. Basically, everything died. The Talltanic site in North Dakota has been found to contain material that came from the impact event that killed the dinosaurs. Embedded in the rock, archaeologists found ancient plants, preserved fish fossils, ancient marine organisms, and even prehistoric mammals. But perhaps more importantly, they also found dinosaur bones and dinosaur eggs. These things are strange to be found together in one single lump. This is the first time that so many random animals have been found inside a small area like this. They were probably grouped together because of the tremors after the impact. The asteroid hitting Mexico caused the oceans to slosh like water in a tub, and these sloshing water propelled sea creatures far inland, where they landed on dry land and died alongside dinosaurs. Most of the fossils found here had likely perished in the minutes or hours immediately following the impact. Number 3. Ancient Chalice. Archaeologists have discovered an ancient Christian chalice that may be rewriting the religious history of the United Kingdom. Archaeologists were shocked to discover a chalice that dates back 1400 years at an old Roman fort in Hexham. The chalice is now the oldest artifact of its kind found in the United Kingdom. It was recovered in fragments from the rubble of the ruined Roman fort, with the director of excavations, Dr. Andrew Bertley, describing it as a very rare find. The chalice was inscribed with angels and crosses and other Christian symbols, but not all of them have been deciphered yet. The reason the chalice is such a strange thing to find in the area is that the Romans had already been long gone when it was made. This suggests that the people in Britain continued Christian worship even after the invading Romans left and took their beliefs with them. Number 2. Lost Islands. Some new archaeological evidence has been found in regard to an incident that happened about 8,000 years ago. Ancient islands have been discovered submerged underneath the North Sea, with researchers believing they initially survived the devastating Storega tsunami that hit Great Britain and the Netherlands in the year 6200 BCE. The tsunami was caused when part of Norway's continental shelf collapsed underwater. The immense wave was thought to have submerged the Doggerland region connecting England's east coast with the European continent, effectively cutting the UK off from the rest of the world. But new research is switching up the story. Based on submerged sediment samples, scientists are now saying that Doggerland may have survived the tsunami along with the now sunken islands in the area. These places may have been inhabited for thousands of years after, all the way into the Stone Age. Researchers are now thinking that there could have been a land bridge between England and Europe for much longer than previously thought, opening the doors to many new theories about the original inhabitants of Britain. But it also raises questions. Like, if Doggerland lasted all the way into the Stone Age, what eventually caused it to sink? Number 1. Bronze Age Tomb. An untouched tomb from the Bronze Age has been discovered in Ireland. And yes, it contains human remains. According to Live Science, the tomb dates back over 3,000 years. It was initially discovered by a workman on a farm. Archaeologists are now saying that the tomb has unusual features and is one of the earliest examples of an ancient burial anywhere in Ireland. The tomb is what scientists call a cist. It's a type of chamber tomb that consists of an underground structure lined with stone, designed to hold any number of burials before being capped with a large sealing stone. What's really fascinating here is that these burials weren't typically practiced until the Bronze Age, no less than 500 years after this one was made. Right now, archaeologists don't know if this was the original inspiration for the chamber tomb or if it was a total fluke 500 years early? Really crazy is that the tomb could even date back as far as 4,500 years. Nothing has been confirmed yet because the radiocarbon dating analysis is still being done by the lab. This discovery is brand new, so we won't even know who was buried inside the tomb yet. But don't worry, we'll have more information probably in a few more months. Which of these discoveries did you think was the best? Let me know about it in the comments, and thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to get all the latest videos from the channel.